coming up, two power pack battle for the final spots in the Kia PBA Playoffs round of eight. First up, former player of the year, EJ Tackett, takes on the Iceman, Jesper Svensson. Then Hall of Famer Tommy Jones will attempt to school up-and-comer Kyle Sherman. Who will move on in the Kia PBA Playoffs? It is time to bowl from a Kegel training center in Lake Wales, Florida, home to the opening rounds of the 2022 Kia PBA Playoffs here on FS1. We have raced to two bowling, win two games in advance, lose and go home. If it's tied 1-1, we'll have a 9th-10th frame roll-off. We started with 16 of the world's best bowlers. Six have moved on. Six have been knocked out on the left side of the bracket. Top-seeded world number one, Jason Belmonte, knocked out by his best friend, Bill O'Neill, the defending champion, Kyle Troop, Tom Barrett. 2019 playoffs winner, Chris Prather, moved on. Early on the right side, Sean Maldonado, A.J. Johnson advancing. Final round of 16 matches here today from Lake Wales. Tackett, Svensson, Tommy Jones, Kyle Sherman. Great bowling for you today. Two former major champions in Svensson and Tackett go head-to-head. What a matchup there. As will legendary Hall of Famer Tommy Jones and young star Kyle Sherman, who won for the first time this year on tour. Welcome back to Lake Wales and the Kia PBA Playoffs. Dave Ryan alongside the Hall of Famer Randy Peterson, rejoined by Kimberly Pressler in a moment. Yeah, the fans are again cheering Randy. Randy, they love you here, partner.
I paid them all. Yeah.
How much?
Not much. I don't have much.
All right. Final round of 16 matches unfold here today. And I want to talk about EJ Tackett. Here's a guy with 15 wins, sure thing Hall of Famer, former major champion. This year, along with Marshall Kent, got his first PBA Tour title win in 3 years. Now he wants to keep the momentum going in one of the toughest events on tour to win.
Yeah, you know, he's had some bad luck. He's been so close. He's made so many telecasts, and he hasn't come away with the W. But, you know, EJ Tackett is one of the best players on the planet. And you can take a look at when he won the doubles with Marshall Kent. He was flawless on that day. There's his doubles partner, Marshall. But he just needs some good fortune, some good breaks to go his way. And EJ Tackett will be back in the winner's circle once again very soon.
Rob Holman, doubles championship with Marshall Kent. Odds to win provided by Fox Bet. Entertainment purposes only, EJ's a big favorite. Head-to-head with Jesper. Let's go to Kimberly with our first two competitors.
Thanks, guys. So, EJ, you won the doubles championship this year, but you're also the average leader, and you've cashed the most the whole season. So what do you have to do today to walk away with a win in the singles?
I'm definitely going to have to strike a lot. Obviously, Jesper's a great competitor, and I expect him to put up some big scores today. So I'm going to have to be on my best, and hopefully at the end of the day, I come away with a win and move on.
Good luck to you today. Now, Jesper, a lot of the athletes have talked about the fact that there is a lot of pin action going on here, and that might benefit someone with your power. So you took some practice shots. Is that statement true?
Might wait till after to answer. No, I mean, EJ is such a powerful player as well, so it's going to be a tough match. But looking forward to a challenge. He's once again proved that he's one of the best players in the world. So got to give it a shot, see what we got.
It's going to be a good match no matter what.
Give it a shot. See what we got. I love it. Look at this matchup. EJ Jesper, head-to-head. Should be fantastic bowling here from Lake Wales.
A 15-time PBA champion, he rolls out of EZ Bowl in Bluffton, Indiana, EJ Tackett.
Well, EJ Tackett, like we said earlier, won the PBA Rob Holman doubles with his partner Marshall Kent. He led the U.S. Open by a bunch, but finished second to Anthony Simonson. One of the strongest strike balls on the tour. EJ Tackett looking to get back into the winner's circle in a singles event.
Playoff history, quarters last year. In Connecticut. Look at that ball reaction as he crunches the 1-3 pocket.
Bowling out of John Scott's Partille Arena in Partille, Sweden, Jesper Svensson.
The Iceman cometh. In 2016, he won the Tournament of Champions, becoming the youngest player to ever do that at age 20. He won the Dave Smalls Best of the Best Championship in Jackson, Michigan. He was the top seed and defeated Packy Hanrahan 248-216 in that title match for his 11th career win.
Three straight round of 16 exits for Jesper at this event. Maybe that changes this year. The Iceman begins today, clutching the 1-2 pocket.
This is going to be a fun and entertaining match. These players are going to be throwing pins everywhere.
Pin action.
Have a re-rack, please.
Early re-rack here for Jesper.
Four pin goes to the sidewall and sends the seven pin into the blue tent for concussion protocol.
Into oblivion. Arsenal for Jesper.
Yeah, pitch black for Jesper Svensson.
I mean, this is quite a matchup for a 314 seed. Wow. Massive talent, massive games out there on the TV pair. Good example. Loves bowling here at KTC, the Kegel Training Center. Feels like it really matches up well with the lanes here. Arsenal for EJ.
Blue Coral Venom for EJ Tackett.
Right lane. Whoa, ring a 10 pin. Looking for a little help, but won't get it.
Good shot, vicious ring and 10 for EJ on the right lane.
Bounced last year by Christian Ascona. Bolero Milford Campbell. 10 pin there. Cross lane for the single pin spare conversion. EJ told us this week, Randy, about what it meant not only to win his first title in a couple of years, the doubles, but for Marshall Kent to win following the passing of his father. Very emotional.
Yeah, you could tell by the way they celebrated after winning.
Hall of Fame credentials from EJ we saw.
Oh.
2-8.
Nice break kicking the 10 out late and just leaving the 2-8. 2-4-10 standing for a moment.
You knew it. He turned away and realized the 8 would stand. Open frame.
As soon as he let go of it, he knew it. Inside a target, slower speed, more hook.
It's very early, just into the third here for Jesper, but chance for a big lead. With the first three of 33 pins. See how he responds off Tackett's open. Seven pin.
Good grief. Might have been the fastest seven pin ever. That follow through.
Man, tremendous power.
Watch how fast the four goes around. It's still bouncing.
I mean, even in slow-mo, it's like a blur. Can't even see that four pin. High percentage at this level to make the seven pin, which he does. Let's take a look at today's Brunswick oil pattern, the Don Carter 39-foot pattern.
39 feet in length and very scoreable, as we've seen throughout the playoffs. And you can see just how the righties and lefties are playing. The only thing that you want to avoid is that extreme outside part of the lane.
Late trip of the 10 pin. Ah, the pin action again here at Kegel. It's awesome. Jesper has been in the state since January 28th. We talked about our different broadcasts of the PBA playoffs about European players or Belmo, Tom Barrett, with families back home. Jesper's not a dad, not a husband, but a lot of his family and friends are back there. Can't wait to return to Europe. EJ returns to a strike.
Just inside third arrow for EJ Tackett. He looks like he's kind of backed his hand out of it just enough to where he doesn't have to play that big hook.
Prior career numbers for EJ at the playoffs. Maybe this is his breakthrough year. Left lane, looking good.
All right, well, that didn't look like he backed his hand out of it. That looked like he got a handful. You see the rev rate and speed. Remember, we watched AJ Johnson yesterday, and AJ was a pretty powerful guy, but he's only in like the 450 range. EJ Tackett, pound for pound, maybe the strongest ball on tour for a player that uses his thumb.
Amazing. Fifth frame, Jesper works on his strike. Goes by 22. Oh! Yep. Pin action, the plates here at Kegel are bouncing around and taking out the seven.
My goodness. Kick plate there, kick plate there. I mean, incredible. Yep. Watch this. That actually came off the bowling ball. It came off the bowling ball, not the kick plates.
Amazing. Jesper, four strikes, five frames. A turkey for a 32-pin lead. You better believe it.
Well, EJ Tackett has dug himself an early hole, and the Iceman's working on a three-bagger. Two of the most powerful players on tour when we come back.
The PBA on FS1. Is sponsored by Visit Central Florida. Plan your next Florida getaway at visitcentralflorida.com. By Guaranteed Rate. Get cash out of your home's equity with a cash out refi from Guaranteed Rate. Learn more at rate.com. And by Kia and the new Forte GT. It's one fantastic ride. Hey, love Del Warren. Weber National head bowling coach, developmental coach here at the Kegel Training Center. So maybe EJ will give up a ball. We'll see. Right now he's thinking about beating Jesper's fence in midway point game one. Race to two.
He better get on his horse and quick.
The cut to 22. That's what you do out of the commercial break.
Remember what he said in his interview with Kimberly? I got to strike and strike a lot. 2016, what a year for him, huh?
Wow. What a career.
Yeah.
15 titles.
You know, he's not even 30 yet.
I mean, amazing talent, trip tap him there. So, yeah, strike streak going. That's what you do. Get back in the match. It's 12-pin difference.
4th, 5th, and 6th frames of pin action for the Iceman. Take a look. My goodness. It's fun to watch. This guy, when he's on, is one of the most exciting players out here.
Totally agree. Okay. And pin. Down you go.
Yeah, they just went down to the warehouse to grab some more pins.
Not much left of these, right?
I mean, just abusing those Brunswick Max pins.
I mean, these guys have been a mainstay so long. You talk about EJ's age. Jesper's only 27.
Yeah.
11 titles, 26 between them. Hall of Fame credentials for each. TOC we talked about for this guy. All going down for both of our star bowlers here.
No need for commentary. Just watch the replay.
Strike streak 9 between these two now. They are rocking. Tackett's got to keep up.
Oh, dang.
Big shot, didn't like it. That's why. Missed the target. Way light. 1, 2, 4.
Remember where I drew those X's?
Mm-hmm.
That's where that ball ended up, and it just can't get it back from there.
Too far. Critical miss puts him in a massive hole in game one. Race to two. Win two games, and you're through to the round of 8. If it's 1-1, a 9th-10th frame roll-off ensues.
Well, if EJ makes this, he's only in the two teens, 214. Jesper Svensson's already in the 240s. Yeah.
The most fearless voice in sports. He's on FS1, the one and only Colin Cowherd, is bold, unique, and outspoken. You can see him on The Herd weekdays on FS1 and the Fox Sports app. Rewrap here called for. He's going to take his time, regroup a bit. Down by 35 pins here in game one. On the right side of the bracket, Maldonado, Johnson have advanced to the round of 8. You see the format. So you can learn a lot in game one, as I'm sure EJ will, thinking about game two. The top two seeds already are out in Belmo and Simonson. That's a high shot, avoided a split, just 3-pin.
So common, you know, it's the overcompensation after getting one wide. You have the tendency to pull the next shot so that you don't go back-to-back wide shots, and we see it all the time.
Take care of the single pin spare conversion. Ninth frame here for Jesper. We have a PAP 6-pack alert. Randy, if he strikes here, he wins $1,000. Sponsored by Pabst Blue Ribbon of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Please remember to drink responsibly. Jesper takes care of business. He strikes. He's got the $1,000. Crack it open, Randy. Crack it open.
Crack open that 6-pack, baby. It's like a wrecking ball going through a straw house.
A straw house has no chance. In this case, the pins have no chance. The PAP 6-pack. Crack it open. Wow, how about that for Jesper? Game one is wrapped up. He's got the bonus from Pabst Blue Ribbon of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Please drink responsibly. Looking for a tap in the seven late here, but all good for Jesper in game one.
Strike track is telling me that Jesper's hit five different boards at the break point, and they've all struck.
Wow.
That's bad news for
that's very bad for
EJ Tackett.
That's showing some versatility. It's coming back where he's putting it in that time.
So three different balls in the 10th frame. Now he's got to make a decision which one to use, right? What do? You flip a coin or do you? I mean, he's going to make an educated guess, don't you think? Yes, he is.
He'll make a good guess.
Yes, he will.
He'll make a big rally in game two. We know that from EJ Tackett, one of the best players on the planet. Game two is next. Convincing win, game one, Jesper Svensson of Sweden. Race to 2 point format leads one game tonight. So wins game two, he is through to the round of eight. If he loses to EJ game two, as Randy talked about before the commercial break, gonna have to make a decision on his bowling ball strategy. All Jesper game one. Including the six-bagger. Game two underway. Whoa! Those pins had no chance whatsoever. Just shrapnel on the pit. Race to two. So, you win the game as Jesper did in game one. Takes game two. He will advance to the round of eight. Joining Maldonado, Johnson, Prather, Tom Barrett, Troop, and Bill O'Neill. If EJ can rally, win game two. We'll have a ninth, 10th frame roll off, and that will be super exciting to watch. EJ, runner up to Simon. Tap on the 10.
And a ball change for EJ Tackett. He goes to a ripcord velocity. The brilliant release of EJ Tackett and the power, you see it right there, and the motion, 10 pin just gets clipped.
Yes.
Nice.
Here we go. EJ's back on track.
Just what we want to see is a good old fashioned bare knuckles brawl.
Man, is that pretty to watch. What a talent. 15 titles, third most of the 16 bowlers beginning PBA playoffs. Of course, Belmo, number one, 29 titles, but he was knocked out by Bill O'Neill. Round of 16. Jesper, okay, resumes his excellence.
The unique style of Jesper Svensson, but the power undeniable.
Began this event with 148 total titles in the field. 34 majors, of course, led by Belmo's record 14. A lot of international success for the Swedish sensation. Same goes Tom Baer of Great Britain. Seven pin.
Again, another violent seven pin for Jesper. Left two in game one.
We saw it earlier, just to point out how tough this event is. Jesper's best in three prior PBA playoffs, round of 16.
Missed just enough to the inside part of the lane where the ball pushes down just a little bit longer, causing that seven pin.
217 plus average for Jesper in PBA playoff action heading into this one. Let's go back to Kimberly.
Well, Dave, I spoke to Brett Spangler, who is the ball rep for EJ, and he said that EJ picked that ball because he needed a big number this game, and that one went through the pins a lot better on the throw. He says it's cleaner and more angular. It's high risk reward because they assume that Jesper is going to shoot a big one this one.
Bigger bowling ball, stronger bowling ball forces him to create more angle, which he's great at.
It's good info. Such a big key what ball is going to get into for the second game.
And when I say bigger ball, I don't mean that the size is bigger. No, the sizes are all the same. Bigger engine.
Throwing good shots.
So all even here after three. Where to go home for EJ? Didn't like it, and 3-6-10 up for him. Could have been worse.
Don't do that.
Yeah, two board miss to the end for EJ. He knew it right away.
Covers with power. I'm at it with a spare ball. He's frustrated.
So bad.
Jesper struck first two frames.
He's yet to miss the pocket.
The 1-2 pocket again.
Well, there's some folks in this competition that feel like Jesper Svensson can win the whole thing. He's got a good enough look on this oil pattern. And the other two lefties have been eliminated. Packy Hanrahan and Jacob Butcher are both gone.
That's right, last one. History in 2016 for Jesper, as Randy talked about.
Come on. Quit throwing it so hard. Man.
Have a great story to tell you about Jesper. I thought I'd tease it to the break.
Okay. So not now, later?
Yeah, it involves an airport.
He didn't like that one. Got the seven, but he's upset he didn't strike on the left lane there.
Well, he was working on a strike, and he could have increased his lead. And instead, it's just three. EJ Tackett now needs to start executing a little bit better than he did in the last frame.
Fifth at the World Series of Bowling, Scorpion event. EJ, back-to-back spares, his fifth frame. Oh, man. 2-10.
Roll it,
split.
EJ. God. Ah.
Well, you heard him say it. Roll it. Roll it, EJ, and he spins this one.
Gets good lane, too.
Gets around the side a little more than he wanted to. And ball hydroplanes.
Just missed it. However, that hurts on a lot of levels. Open frame, lost count. Big momentum for Jesper heading into the break.
Okay.
Much better. Much better.
And it'll be an eye pin. Sweet as that, for sure, for EJ Tackett.
Well, EJ Tackett trying to claw his way back into this after an open in the fifth. But when we come back, I'll tell you a story about Jesper Svensson and I spending a little bit of time in an airport.
Kegel Training Center, home of Wood International, great collegiate program. Dale Warren, one of the directors of bowling here, and the head coach of the school from Babson Park nearby. A legend around these parts. A lot of support, to be sure. Jesper, 17-pin lead, and the story, Randy, about Jesper in the airport was?
So he ends up finishing third at the Players Championship, like in 2017. Honestly, it was in Columbus at Wayne Webb's place. And he needs a ride to the airport. He's flying back to Sweden. So I said, well, I'll give you a ride. I'm going straight to the airport. Hold that thought. So, get to the airport. Got a little bit of time before our flight. And I'm like, Jesper, are you 21 yet? And he said, yeah, I just turned 21. And I said, oh, man, how about a beer? He goes, oh, I'd love one. And we had a beer together, and he made me pay after winning all that money.
So you bought?
I bought Jesper a beer, yeah.
Well,
and he was just a couple days past his 21st birthday.
Boy, think he would have paid. I mean, with all the dough. Here's Jesper left lane. All right. Well, I bet since then he's bought you a couple.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's a great guy to hang out with, no doubt. I know he's one of your favorites.
He's my spirit animal.
Yeah.
He's killing it right now.
Trouble for Tackett. Big trouble. Seventh frame needs this one. Got it. That's what you do.
Well, we lost our one seed in Belmonte, our two seed in Anthony Simonson, and now our three seed, EJ Tackett, is very close to being eliminated. It's down 17 with another strike in the eighth. He can cut it to seven. But you see the max scores there. Svensson 259, Tackett 242.
Seven pins, big strike from EJ.
Still has life. In his mind right now, he's like, if I strike out and Jesper leaves one more seven pin, I can capture game two and send it to overtime.
All right, 10 frame roll off. Right lane, Jesper trying to stay hot. Looking for the hit on the six pin and can't get it.
Well, he got that ball into the middle part of the lane again. Good three board miss.
It's a big non-strike working on a double, so.
And that's exactly what EJ Tackett was waiting for. An opportunity given to him by Jesper.
Take a re-rack here. Six pin. Svensson lead. Game two. Jesper won the first game in the race that's here.
Thank you.
Final show of a round of 16 matches. The top 16 players in the world beginning the Kia PBA playoffs. On the points list, we've seen some shocking upsets early. The first match out of the gate, Bill O'Neill, the 16th seed, beat his best friend and top seeded Jason Beaumont. Jones and Sherman on the way. Eighth and final open round match. Svensson left lane, looking for help. Got it. Cross the deck. Down goes the seven pin.
Seven pin got ganged up on here. A couple of pins coming after it. Yeah. He's saying that the shot on the right lane was him, all him.
All right, EJ's got his opportunity. Foundation frame, looks for the four bagger, looks for a lead. Gets it done.
Well, he needs two more and seven to send it to a roll off.
Last year he beat Chris Prager in the round of 16 in a roll off, lost in the quarterfinals in Connecticut at the playoffs to Christian Ascona in a roll-off. And that's what he needs to force another roll-off, this time against Jesper Svensson. Didn't like it. Got a Brooklyn anyway.
Oh, my goodness.
A big miss. But that's okay.
Oh my goodness. Well, he's been on the other side of that. That's one of the best breaks he's gotten in a long time.
Takes a re-rack. We have a Pabst six-pack alert. PJ strikes here, $1,000. He'll win it. Sponsored by Pabst Blue Ribbon of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Please remember to drink responsibly. Striking seven. Shut out Jesper. And we'll have a ninth, 10th frame roll off. Haven't had one of those on the right side of the bracket yet. Maldonado swept Simonson. Johnson swept Butrev in the prior two right bracket round of 16 matches. Left lane. Okay. That's no Brooklyn strike. Eight tattoos to one free pocket. $1,000 as well. Crack it open, RP. Crack it open. That's six pack for EJ.
Seven or redder.
Strike again, seriously? Well, he needed seven. He gets 10. He's got the game to win. We're going to have a roll off.
Two Brooklyns in the 10th.
I'm not sure I've ever seen that. Hey, whatever works if you're EJ Tech.
I mean, that may have been a shot where he just wanted to make sure that he didn't get it too far to the right and it hit that OB out there. Well, Tackett's the higher seed, so he'll choose which lane he wants to start on.
So game two is complete. Jesper will finish things out here. See the max scores. Tackett has wrapped it up. Third straight match in the PBA playoffs. EJ is going to face a roll off. One up, one down, last two. Big one here against Jesper coming up.
Correct. So, but I feel like I have to start just to get finished on this. Yeah.
Got some knowledge from Brett Sprangler. Tour rep wraps up.
I'll start.
Game two. Tell tournament director John Weber he will start. And the roll-off rules, ninth and 10th
going to roll-off.
Higher seed will choose the order. That is EJ Tackett. Higher pinfall wins it. If tied, we'll have a one-ball roll-off, which is incredibly exciting. The max score is 60. So for the first time on the right side of the bracket, here we go, the roll-off. Two of the first three round of 16 matches, left side of the bracket, went to a roll. This is it. Win or go home in the Kia PBA playoffs. Roll off begins. Tackett, nice start.
No Brooklyn there.
So critical, lead off in the roll off with a strike. Jesper needs to respond. Top break, six pin.
His max now is 50. EJ Tackett's max is 60. An unbelievable break for Tackett. That last game, that first ball in the 10th frame where he crosses over. I mean, because it looked like Svensson was just going to run away with this.
Impressive in game one. Great start game two. Tackett took advantage of a late nine spare that he needed desperately from Jesper. Close out game two. And if you don't strike on the ninth, you're in trouble.
He's
six pin again.
Big trouble now.
Oh. What once looked so promising for Jesper Svensson of Sweden is now.
Do we get any reaction to roll?
Very difficult scenario to try to win.
Okay, can I have mine, please?
Re-rack here for Jesper, Randy.
Yep, well, he's in big trouble. I mean, EJ Tackett, no matter what Jesper does on this shot, EJ just needs to go spare strike and it's over.
Wow. 10 pin this time.
Spare and nine. Tackett is moving on. See if he can take advantage of that wonderful break in game two. Jesper never missed the pocket.
You saw what he needs. Whoa, watch it.
Has to make it. He has to cover this.
Oh, my goodness. 2-4-6-10 split. Can you believe it?
Nope. Cannot. Got to get it over here. Cut that two pin into the 6-10. The ball will take out the four. Has to convert.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, EJ.
Oh, my gosh.
Not over yet. He's got to make it.
Oh. Missed it. How about that? Just a shocking finish. And on the bench, Jesper Svensson wins the match. Shocking. And for EJ Tackett.
Man, you got to feel for EJ.
Oh.
Unbelievable. Last thing I thought would happen. Wow.
Jesper dominant game one. Late failure game two, and in the roll-off surprise finish, Jesper Svensson is through to the round of eight, and the third seed has now been knocked out. Top seeded Belmo, second seeded Simo, third seeded EJ, all done. Jones and Sherman still to come. The Hall of Famer against the young star who got his first PBA Tour win in 2022. Let's see it again, Randy. What happened?
The location didn't look bad, but he may have just missed it off his hand because with a good hand there, it gets off of that spot. It just looked like he maybe missed it at the bottom.
Back to Kimberly.
Well, Jesper, my goodness, you walk away with the win, but you look disappointed after your shot in the roll-off. My goodness, what went through your mind when you saw he had that split?
Well, I thought I lost it for sure. You never really want to win like that, but you know, it happens, and it's sad for EJ, and I feel for him, but happy about my performance, you know, and of course I wanted the ball a little bit higher roll off, but it is what it is. I take it, I move on, and you know, yeah, I bowled a pretty good match, so I still think I deserve it, but it's a little bitter aftertaste to win like that.
Well, Randy said that all through the match that you did not miss the pocket at all, but then you were having some issues striking. What was happening?
Well, the lane transition a little bit, and down the stretch, I maybe didn't throw the best of shots. So human factor for sure, and try to clean that up and go at it again next round.
Well, congratulations. You're advancing to the round of eight.
The Iceman to the quarterfinals. It was not easy. Wow. Tommy Jones and Kyle Sherman set to go head-to-head from Lake Wells and the Kegel Training Center next. The Kia PBA Playoffs here on FS1. Kia PBA Playoffs rolling on. Coverage continues next Sunday at FS1. New Eastern begin quarterfinal action right here from the Kegel Training Center in Lake Wales, Florida. Bill O'Neill, Kyle Troop, the defending champ, Tom Barrett, and Chris Prather, who won this event in 2019. Can't wait for those tremendous round of eight matches. Yeah, Troop, there it is. The pro with a throw. Pick it out, Kyle. Pick it out. Jones, Sherman, next match. All even odds to win, provided by Fox Bet. Let's go to Kimberly with our two competitors.
Thanks, Dave. So, Tommy, you have referred to yourself as the veteran out here, and in our pre-show interviews, you said you're trying to stay ahead of the curve against the young guns like Kyle. How are you going about doing that?
Yeah, these guys are changing the game year after year. It's just changing so fast. So, you know, every now and then when they're practicing a little bit, I'll get some videos of him and a couple of the other guys and just try to see if I can get my body as close to that as possible and try to still be able to compete with these guys.
Kyle, what do you think about the fact that this Hall of Famer is out here scouting videos of you?
Well, I do the exact opposite. I go back and watch him and Bill and all the other guys, see what all they did to be as successful as they are. So I do the opposite of him.
I love it. Good luck to both of you guys.
Kimberly, thanks. Kyle Sherman, half of the Brad and Kyle YouTube channel. That's going to be a great matchup here. Kyle, the young star. Tommy Jones, the Hall of Famer. Head-to-head from Kegel next. Wales getting set to resume the 2022 Kia PBA Playoffs. Jones, Sherman, head-to-head, round of 16, the final round of 16 match to advance to the quarterfinals.
He bowls out of Golden Lanes in Simpsonville, South Carolina. PBA Hall of Famer Tommy Jones.
Yeah, Tommy Jones, 20 titles on the PBA Tour, two majors, but who can forget back in 2020 when he got inducted into the Hall of Fame and about 16 hours later pulled a perfect 300 game in the title match. That's TJ, that's Tommy Jones.
Unforgettable. 27th all time. You're on a game on TV, there have been 31 total now. 32 with Chris Vai last year. Elder statesman of our 16 bowlers to begin this event. About to start Tommy Water with a 2-4.
Well, it's easier now that the 5-pin fell. Tommy working that tape.
43 years old, 22 years a pro. As Kimberly talked about with Kyle, as you see his playoff history. Not in the top of the rankings, two of the 3 years. Oh, I like it. Yeah, look down. It's a miss. It's an open frame early. Game one.
Rolling out of St. Charles Lanes in St. Charles, Missouri, Kyle Sherman.
This year's World Series of Bowling, Kyle finally broke through with his first singles win. It was the PBA Cheetah Championship in Wauwatosa, Wisconsin. He was the second seed. He defeated Chris Kelso and then Christian Ascona for his first career singles title.
Gotta feel so good. Yes. Brad Miller, who's here watching.
Kyle and Brad show.
That's right, man.
On YouTube.
YouTube channel. Wildly popular.
Check it out.
Brad's here, one of their new employees, Dennis, is here. We're watching. You know, there's going to be a lot of content coming from the PBA playoffs. Brad Miller lost in this event to Chris Prater in round 16. And Kyle starts with the 7-pin. Kyle, the 11th seed, his buddy Brad, the 12th seed. I mean, they are kind of inseparable. I mean, thick as thieves, those two. Arsenal for Kyle. Seven pin got a spare. We talked about when we have covered Brad before. There were nights with the Brad and Kyle show on YouTube where they'd be editing together for 3 hours a night. Now they've hired two employees to make it a lot easier. Up to 90,000 views a day. They're doing really well with that. Now it's all about the bowling. Whoa! Way high. 3-6-10.
That ball, like, really stood up quick. Watch this. He's playing way in. And then, I mean, right there, it, like, hit the brakes and went left.
Can't cover.
It's just not a pretty
stance. Open frame. Given right back by the 11 seed.
Tommy going with a purple hammer, urethane. In the unusual way that he puts his hand in the ball, thumb first, then twists his fingers to the side. Fingers going last. Typically, it's the other way around. Shot here by Tommy. Misses that spare in the first. Remember back at the Tournament of Champions where Tommy was having some issues with his thumb. He kept messing around with tape. Got up, left a seven pin, and then missed it.
So perhaps reminiscent. And that's a better adjustment. Great shot.
I don't think we've seen anybody throw urethane quite that fast, with the exception of Jesper Svensson.
Kyle Sherman, someone Tommy Jones has been studying. See what the younger guys are doing these days. Of course, Kyle has great admiration for TJ.
Kyle worked really hard on his game. He's made a couple of changes. One of them, and he actually lowered his backswing. Tommy's still working on the tape.
Tommy's big message to us about Kyle's game, that the right shoulder is lower on the approach, that bowlers now are taught much differently than when he was learning. Tommy was taught to keep his shoulders and hips open and look out there. Wow.
Stop there, man.
1-2-8-10, washing out.
Ball over here to the left side of the head pin, cut it over into the 10.
Top one, and just gets the one pin, loses count. Open frame, wow. Jones on the bench, sees the lead balloon to 29 by 16 pins on the mess. So Tommy, the opening frame open, and since then a double. One of the many great accolades, player of the year back in 05-06. What a talent, what a career. Jones. Tap on the 10 across the deck. Down you go, 10 pin, down you go.
A 10 pin looks like it could use a Snickers right about now. Just got assaulted.
guys. Turkey early here, game one, and a nice lead for Tommy Jones. The Bear Frame is sponsored by Pabst Blue Ribbon of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Grabs a Pabst today, and please drink responsibly.
How long did it take you to get to where you could actually say grabs a Pabst?
It's one of my favorite phrases. It's so cool.
I mean, it didn't take you long. It's like toy boat. You know, you had to practice that a lot. It just, like, came
unique
out.
Unique New York.
Yeah. All right, Ron.
Unique New York. Ring it 10-pin there for TJ.
Grabs a Pabst.
You have to really look at the card, make sure you're really, I got to read that.
I think it's a great saying.
It's awesome.
Yeah, he's going really straight, real direct with the urethane ball with speed. And here's his spare ball that he had a little trouble with, and it was taping up. No trouble this time.
10-pin got that. Was on a strike streak of the turkey, so no four-bagger. 9 spare for TJ. Now Sherman's got to regroup here. There's Brad Miller, his best buddy. Half of the YouTube channel. He was knocked out by Chris Prather. 2-0, left side of the bracket in the round of 16. Good year for Brad, though. His best friend makes a nice adjustment right lane and crunches all 10 into the pin.
Kyle Sherman's orb of choice for this first game, UFO alert. And he's really got his hand up the back of it, trying to get it to roll and stop.
Great young bowlers battling for that first career title. Kyle got his. On the single side. Got a strike there to make things interesting, game one.
Nice comeback for Kyle. After two opens, he's on a double, but the lead right now belongs to Tommy Jones.
The online graphics you see today, including the ball tracer, courtesy of Clutch Bowling, looking awesome, looking amazing, as always.
Love me some Clutch.
Love me some great competition as well here at the Kia PBA Playoffs on FS1. Final round of 16 match. Dave, Kimberly, Randy with your entire fantastic Fox Sports PBA crew. So it's game one, race to two. Win two games, you're through. If it goes to roll off like earlier with Svensson Tackett, 9th, 10th frame roll off. Sixth frame, Jones works on a spare. Comes through.
Walking away from it.
Hey, Dave, do you know where Tommy Jones' first title came?
Where did it come from?
Tokyo, Japan. The Japan Cup.
Japan Cup.
He owns 3 of those.
What a career. 6 feet. Well, Tommy's 43. Strikes there. Said it was this week. I'm going to keep bowling as long as I feel competitive with the young stars. He was utterly shocked. And so impressed Norm Duke was able to get to the Masters final at 58 this year as the top seed.
I mean, after what Norm did, winning back-to-back, when was that, 2019?
2 titles, yeah.
We went back-to-back on dual patterns. I mean, I'm not surprised by anything Norm Duke does. Good shot.
Whoa, ring a 10-pin. Good effort from Sherman on the right lane.
Yeah, look at the numbers, positions at the arrows. Right there, perfect. And he gets 9.
crazy game.
It's not fair, Randy. It's not fair. Two career titles, one on the single side. Also the Lucy for Kyle. No majors yet. 2022. Big breakthrough has the 10th pin. Has its mark. Head to PBA.com to subscribe to our YouTube channel for classic telecast tournament highlights, exclusive content at the Kia post show. Go to PBA.com, click the YouTube link, and subscribe to catch all the action. Kyle needs strikes. Left lane. Five pin.
What?
Yeah. So big hole game one, race to two. Hands are up. Everybody's got to get their hand up.
Kyle can make this with his eyes closed.
Oh, I missed it.
I mean, I think you put your hand up in case somebody misses the five. It's the easiest spare on the board, right? It's right in the middle of the lane. And if they miss the five pin, everybody that has their hand up gets beer or something. I don't know.
Free beverage.
Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Here's our player comparison. Obviously, Tommy Jones going much straighter. He's the ball on the right, the blue one, and the red one is Kyle Sherman. And two completely different ways to play this 39-foot hole pattern.
Jones. Center goes down late. Big shot. Huge lead. Game one, race to two. One game in his career at the PBA Playoffs so far for Tommy Jones. That's been it. First round 2020, lost, shot at 214. That's all for the Hall of Famer. There's been some great talent, never won this event.
A little better.
Like that better? For good reason.
I'll tell you what, 43 years old, he still has plenty of punch and plenty of power. Look at that, 468 rev rate. After an open in the first, Tommy Jones is going to win game one. Kyle Sherman changing balls.
Looking ahead of game two for Kyle. Final round of 16 match, all getting to the quarterfinals. O'Neill, Troop, Barrett, Prather, Maldonado, Johnson, Svensson have won their opening round matches so far. Wow, look at this lead. For TJ. 60 pins in the opener.
Shit. Well, he went to a trend two and he didn't move his feet, just changed balls.
Shot down the face.
It's the first ever TV matchup between these two. Wow. Great shot.
Yep. He's going to look at another ball.
Yeah, now it's about momentum for game two, right?
Yeah, it's about that. It's about getting some confidence in what you're going to do to try to get this match even.
Spare.
Well, that's probably the one he's going to go with in game two. But he did the right thing. He had to check some different reactions, try a couple of different bowling balls to see if he could create a little bit different shape. Tommy now is going to reactive resin.
Officially has the win now, leaves the 8 pin, and Tommy Jones does win game one. So always interesting to see what Tommy's working on experimenting with in the last couple shots of the 10th frame. Tommy's wrapped this one up. Kyle needs game two win. Send this to a 9th, 10th frame roll-off. Tommy Jones, Randy, the Hall of Famer at 43, looking pretty good in game one. TJ Sherman, game two on the way from Lake Wales. These gorgeous videos, courtesy of Visit Central Florida. Some golf. A little fishing. So many lakes in this area. It's fantastic. Of course, Legoland is about a 15-minute drive. Some wakeboarding as well.
There goes Danny, Dave. There goes Dave again.
Definitely not me. Boy, I wish. Fun to watch. Jones, Sherman. TJ leads. Blasting Kyle in game one. Now Sherman, who experimented in the 10th frame with a couple different balls. It's all about game two. Got to flush that first game, move on to the second. Tommy wins it. He sweeps, moves on to the round of eight.
Bro, stop being so modest. You know that was you on that wakeboard.
If only I had hair like that. Left lane, get started game two. That leaves a 2-pin.
It almost looks like Kyle needs a little bit more side rotation to get the ball to come around the corner. There's too much up the back, and that's making the ball quit, especially when he gets it to the right. Too much up the back.
Takes care of the spare.
You know, it's interesting. Tommy's using urethane. Kyle's using reactive resin. Kyle won his very first singles title, Cheetah. Kyle used urethane. Now, I get it. Two different patterns.
Right.
But
still.
Yeah. Hey.
Here's the Hall of Famer.
Nice. Well, he gave the reactive ball a look, and he went right back to the ball he won game one with. Both Cheetah and this pattern, a little bit of the shorter patterns on the PBA Tour. And that's why this urethane comes into play right around second arrow.
No worries in game one for Tommy. Interesting, they each studied each other, right?
Yeah.
Kyle always looking up to the Hall of Famer. Tommy trying to keep up with the young guys. Left lane. Well, right now it's Tommy Jones with a great start, nice lead in game two.
Still got it. What a career. 20 wins. Couple majors.
He's locked in right now. All right, the youngster got to get going here. That's high. 4-7. Standing.
Four,
92% conversion at this level. Usually no problem for these great bowlers. Spare of the game, sponsored by Guaranteed Rate. If you believe it, you can do it. Guaranteed Rate, believe you will. Kyle comes through. Randy, no problem.
Last time we did this, somebody made the 210 a couple frames later.
Well, that's good. We might see a really exciting make then on a split.
Just saying, I want to make sure that Guaranteed Rate gets their just due.
Absolutely.
You know, something really cool.
But Kyle doesn't want to face the 210.
I get it.
Left lane for the youngster. That looks good.
Well, see the reaction of this ball here. Yeah, that was better. Again, just a little more side rotation to get it to come around the corner. Gets it to push a little bit easier through the front part of the lane, and then it gets it to come around the corner.
Jones trying to continue his perfect start. Game two, we'll do it. Weekday mornings, Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp go head-to-head on the day's hottest sports topics, undisputed with Skip and Shannon. Days from 9:30 a.m. to noon Eastern, only on FS1 and the Fox Sports.
Shannon Sharp looks like he could still play.
What a talent he was. Great show. You guys are amazing. So the first three here for Tommy, fifth at the TOC. Roll off. Sean Maldonado, who, by the way, knocked off the second-seeded Anthony Simonson in the round of 16 at this event. With an injured back. Boom! Trip 10 pin. Oh, Tommy Jones looking good. To begin game two, the front four in a 32-pin lead.
Think he wanted this one? Watch this reaction if we get it. Tommy looks like he's been working out.
He looks good, doesn't he? I know he plays a lot of golf. He's out there several times a week when he can. Really good golfer. Sherman works on a strike. 22 does just that. Big shot for the former collegiate star at Lindenwood for the 2014 Intercollegiate National Championship team.
Looks like a little bit more side rotation, and the ball's actually reading this oil pattern better.
Three-time second-team All-American at Lindenwood. Four-time academic All-American. That's incredibly impressive. Accounting major. First one, Turkey, cut it to 12. Will not get there. Yeah. 2-5.
And there's that shot again that kind of rolls out and quits.
Despair.
Tommy Jones has been within 8/10 of an inch at his break point for the last four frames.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Looks here for the nickel, the front five. And a 34-pin lead. Game two, won the first game. No problem. Right lane for TJ. Looking for some help.
Oh.
on 10 pin.
Almost.
A little bit of doubt there, maybe for a moment.
It was a little thin.
Mm-hmm. Let's see how thin, Randy. Okay, enough. Plenty. Based on his reaction, I was a little worried for a second there. He looked down.
I saw a guy miss that one of those to lose a U.S. Open once.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh, bucket lead.
John, tape.
He's going back to tape on the spare ball, I believe. Let's see which bowling ball he puts this tape in. Can't tell. Can't see it. Took some out. Putting some more back in. Spare ball. Yep.
Covers it all right.
Yep.
Are the pins still there? They left, or they just get away?
I mean, look at the sideboard action there. Is that incredible?
Yeah. Halfway home, game two. Kyle Sherman needs a rally to keep this match going. Tommy Jones wants to close out the youngster and advance to the round of eight. The PBA on FS1 is sponsored by Guaranteed Rate. Get cash out of your home's equity with a cash-out refi from Guaranteed Rate. Learn more at rate.com. And by Kia and the new Forte GT. It's one fantastic ride. Brad and Kyle channel, yeah, it's very popular on YouTube. Some of the Weber International players are here at their home bowling center watching. Kyle Sherman down by 19 pins to the Hall of Famer, Tommy Jones, who leads one game to none. It's a race to two. Kyle works on a spare out of the break. The time is now for Kyle Sherman. Six-year pro, only 28. Tremendous talent, right lane, yes.
Good one there, and he can cut it to nine if he strikes again in the seventh. Beautiful game. You see the max scores.
That is nine pins.
Is splicing boards at the arrows. Last couple of shots on that left lane.
Open-handed release, love that. No grab.
That's how you respond out of the break. Seventh frame, Jones works on ace pair. Wow. The 10 is down. The strike puts him in good shape.
This dude's pillow is cool on both sides. Tommy Jones just threads another one on that right lane. Now looking to go back up by 19. Remember last time on this lane, he left the bucket.
Ten pin.
Now 245 max for Jones, 256 max for Sherman.
Tommy's offered some advice to Kyle. Started his career. We asked Tommy this week who helped him. He said Jason Couch, Chris Barnes, Brian Purcell. Instrumental in his development. Always helps to have the veterans help you out. Sherman needs it. Sherman gets it. Oh, the 10 pin.
What hit it?
Late arrival. And a lead for Sherman.
Kegel carry. Yep. I think the six pin.
I think so too. Yeah.
Created a vortex and just kind of sucked the 10 pin off the deck. You talk about this mentorship. Right. Why do you think all the young players want to play a practice round with Tiger Woods?
Yeah. Learn so much. Not just the game, it's what goes into the game, right?
Yep.
Sherman by a pin now. Go by 11. Whoa, that misses the mark. And the 1-2-4 stance.
Look at that big miss to the right. So not only was the location bad, the hand was bad as well. He was lucky to kick the 10 out. Missed it.
Oh my goodness.
It's tough to get a mark when you don't hit the one in front.
Wow. Missed the head pin. Jones now on the bench, a 14 pin lead. And a meltdown for Kyle late. You do not give the Hall of Famer this kind of opportunity. Script, flip, Jones, okay.
Come on.
One more strike in the 10th frame and it's over. It'll put Tommy to the 230s. Max score for Kyle Sherman, 221.
Spare and seven, that's all Tommy needs. Jones strikes! And Tommy Jones gets it done. Satisfying moment of the match, sponsored by Snickers. Nothing satisfies like a Snickers. Late trouble for Sherman spells victory for Tommy Jones.
One shot cost Sherman.
Amazing. Svensson looked like he was going to go down late. EJ Tackett. The roll off went to Jesper. He's through to the round of eight. Tommy Jones. Takes down Kyle Sherman. Now the Hall of Famer will take on Jesper Svensson in the next round. All the 16, round of 16 matches are complete. O'Neill, Troop, Barrett, Prather, Maldo, Johnson, Jesper, Svensson, Tommy Jones. The round of eight, the quarterfinals are set at the 2022 Kia PBA Playoffs. Playoff coverage continues next Sunday here on FS1 at noon Eastern. We start the quarterfinal action. We saw the matchups a moment ago. Don't forget to head to PBA YouTube channel in just a few minutes for the PBA post show presented by Kia. Now for the entire crew, Randy Peterson and Kimberly Pressler, it's Dave Ryan saying so long from the Kegel Training Center here in Lake Wales, Florida. You've been watching the PBA on FS1. The round of eight is set for this year's Kia PBA Playoffs.